Ron DeSantis right there. Hurricane Helene is now entering into the Gulf of Mexico, the lower part of it, right out of the Yucatan Channel. It's on track to become a major league hurricane. You're talking about a major hurricane category 3 or possibly more, and it's got Florida squarely in its sights right now, and the entire west side of Florida is going to be under the gun. You're going to be raked by this thing as it rips up to your north. It's going to stretch out there with danger from the Keys through the Florida Big Bend area, including Tampa, St. Pete, and then points to the north, including Atlanta, Georgia, with flooding and tree damage. We'll talk all about that coming up. Fox Weather has team coverage as well, stationed all across the southeast. Helene's going to hit tomorrow, and we've got everybody in place already. So we've got guys right now all the way ringing around Florida into the Big Bend. I will be driving out there and flying out to Atlanta. That's after the story hits. It's going to be moving up in that direction, and that means a lot of power outages. So after the show, I'm in Atlanta for the inland damage threat. It's going to be one of those storms that we're all going to remember. But first, we need to track this out. So we've got people positioned out across the region, unfortunately, in a danger zone again. We're looking at regions right there by Keaton Beach, and this is in Florida. It's hot, it's humid already, but at least the weather is okay to get things prepped, at least for the time being. You've got another good, maybe less than 24 hours before the main stuff begins to affect you guys. Mike Seidel is out there. He's been out there for the entire morning long. I know it's hot. I can see it right there. You're talking about dew point temperatures in the 70s. Feels like the upper 90s. But, Mike, at least it's not blowing you over at this point.
No, I've got a good flop sweat going back here, Bob, if you know what I mean.
Oh, yeah.
And I hope you get out of New York. You fly down to LaGuardia or get down to ATL because it's gotten kind of a stormy, at least on the north side of Atlanta. They've already had lightning and thunder and gusty winds. So this is saturating the ground and making it more, unfortunately, positive for trees to get uprooted. And all the rain coming in tomorrow night and Friday. But that's another story. First, let's deal with the location here. Keaton Beach, Deco Beach, Steinhatchee here in Taylor County, where there's a mandatory evacuation for the entire county. And this is really, this area in the Big Bend is ground zero. It's hard to believe that it's going to go any farther west with that big trough coming in to the middle of the country. It may jog a little farther east before it makes landfall, but the bottom line is it doesn't really matter. This area is going to get hammered with surge. And I've been talking about the surge through the morning hours. Let me show you this palm tree right here. And the bottom frond, the lowest frond, I'm estimating at about 15 feet. And imagine a wall of water coming in and getting up to that frond. And that's the maximum. They're forecasting 10 to 15 feet of surge to the hurricane center. Normally high ground at time of high tide, but as I mentioned, the tidal range here is only about 7 or 8 inches. You know, you get into where I'm from, Maryland, Delaware, it's about this much from low tide to high tide. Here it's nominal, minimal, so it really doesn't matter, but I can tell you low tide tomorrow is at 5:33 p.m. Eastern. So we have the surge issue right here coming in, and so when you have surge, you got to build those houses up. And the building codes really changed after the superstorm of 1993. That was in March 12th and 13th, and the surge here in the Big Bend was 8 feet. Now, this is like a winter storm, but the pressure really bombed out. And these homes over here, I get Robert to walk through the sand. And Bob, if you don't have shoes on today, you'll get certainly first-degree burns on your feet. That's how hot it is out here with the sand. Oh. But there's the building near the house, and we've been showing you this through the morning hours. That first level is up about 20 feet. And what we've noticed is, and you can see now the change, they have boarded up the windows. They have not finished yet, and that owner does not have those shutters where you can just pull them shut, like we saw yesterday over at St. George Island. This house, they headed for the hills. They pulled out their camper and got out of harm's way. This house is not nearly as high. I'd say about 8 or 9 feet above the sea level. So they may end up with water in the first floor. But you look around here and then across the bay, and you see a lot of homes that are built way, way up. That white house there, the third one down, that one's about as high as this one. That one's up a good 20 feet, too. So those houses are going to be fine. There are no trees around them that are going to hit the roofs. So their only concern really is the surge, which will stay under the houses. The surge goes away. It rains. The roofs are hurricane proof for the most part. They've got the, you see, it's not a shingled roof. It's an aluminum roof. So those are what you see in hurricane territory. So Bob, these homes that are high enough up are going to come through in okay shape. the power may be out. Now, with Michael, the power was out 9 days here. They had power out for about a week with Idalia. That was about a year ago. So this is really turning into like a mini Hurricane Alley. This Big Bend area was hit earlier by Debbie this year.
Yeah.
And the power was out for up to a week in some areas. And now I talked to some sheriff officers earlier, and they said, well, the trees that came down are already down, so maybe we'll be in better shape. That's a nice thought, but there's still a lot of trees around here because this area didn't get really, you know, raked like areas just off to our west around Mexico Beach and Port St. Joe, where you drive on 98 and you really don't see any trees except these big denuded logs, dead trees sticking up out of the ground.
You know, and those palm trees, they can take a good beating when it comes to wind and rain, but that salt water is not good for them at all. You're absolutely right. Watching your live shots right now, Mike, I don't see anybody behind you. You've got mandatory evacuations where you are?
Yep. The whole county. Whole county. I mentioned earlier, the only other time I remember, maybe you remember another county, Monroe County, the Florida Keys, they've mandatory evacuated the entire county. But I've never seen any other counties do the whole county. The locals here are used to evacuations where we're standing, these barrier islands, these low-lying beaches, Steinhatchee, Keaton here, and Deco Beach. But other than that, like in Perry, there's even a mandatory evacuation there. That's the county seat. That's where they have the Walmart and the McDonald's, and that's where we're staying. We've got a sturdy hotel, and we'll be fine there. There's no trees really close to the hotel. And the other issue is we don't have to worry about surge there. We'll see how it shakes out as far as flash flooding in those areas. But we can get up to higher ground in the hotel.
Yeah, I was
worried
about...
So we're going to be safe tomorrow.
Yeah.
It's just going to be trying to figure out what happens, you know, how many roads are blocked by trees. Can you get around on Friday when the sun comes back out? You know, it remains to be seen.
Yeah, that's going to be the main thing. And you would say, okay, we're kind of out of tourist season, but we're not because it's fall break for schools in the Atlanta metro. And guess where they all usually go? Down to the Florida Panhandle. So, yeah, there's some people that need to be evacuated. Mike, he's our storm specialist. I appreciate you, Mike. We'll check back in with you in a little bit. All right, let's get a look at this. More pictures coming in from, this is a live look. That's our camera. We've got position right there at the Key West. I guess it's beer 30. Everybody's gone. Look at that, though. You got the waves that are starting to slash on in. There's a nice splash mark right here. Florida coastline set to see major impacts out of this thing, especially later on today as the waves continue to build, calling for as much as a 10 to 15 foot storm surge north of there. We're not talking about the Keys right now. We're talking about all the way up to areas right by the Big Bend of Florida. So here's that satellite imagery. You can see where we're watching. You can see a nice swirl in the atmosphere, and that is our Hurricane Helene, 80-mile-per-hour sustained wind storm right now. We're going to zip underneath the cloud cover at this point, show you where the radar is located, and that's some heavy rain. The outermost bands now, right across Cuba into the Florida Strait. Some lightning popping out there also. You can see Key West as it pops up on your screen. Rain is essentially off to your west and down to your south. We've got a couple of streamers coming in, right areas by, looks like the Bahamas into the coast of Florida. So we've got some thunderstorms that are out there. So that's what it looks like up here. You get to the Florida Panhandle, more storms are there, and you can see the exclusive Fox model. Everything is rolling up to the north. So there you are, Fort Myers, getting scraped by some rain showers. Those are the outer bands. That's tomorrow morning, about 8 o'clock. Up by the Panama City, some very heavy rain out there also. So that is all stretching up to lower sections of Georgia, into North Georgia, the Carolinas, too. And ultimately, it rains itself out. That combined with an upper-level load, it's positioned right there by the Tennessee Valley. It's going to be a very heavy rainmaker inland. And you're talking about probably 10 to 15 inches of rain for the North Carolina mountains into upstate South Carolina and some of these spots. So let's look right now, though, at the wind forecast. And as it comes in tomorrow afternoon, it appears that its strongest winds are going to be right before landfall, like it always is, and that will be sometime after dark. So sunset, it's going to be dark at this point. You're talking about Friday, 3 a.m. Winds are starting to come on down. Peak winds, though, could be higher than 100 miles per hour. I know it says 80 to 90 in Tallahassee, but if you've got a 125 mile per hour sustained wind storm, that's the forecast coming in at you. It's not going to slow down for crap when it gets to your region because that's so much momentum. So take this very seriously. Get up to north a bit farther. It's a big wall of rain coming in and a big wall of water. That water is going to be the saltwater flooding. That's the storm surge flooding. That's an area shaded in purple. So anywhere up to 15 foot storm surge doesn't mean everybody there is going to see it, but it does mean you have a good potential of seeing that, especially around the high tide area where you had a couple of inches of total on that as well. Windfall, look at this. The wind forecast for Port Charlotte, 60 to 70 mile per hour gusts. That's at the peak right here. Here comes the rain also. That yellow shaded area is good 2 to 3 inches of rain. Fort Myers, a little bit more, maybe 4 to 5. Then you get inland, the wind is going to pick up as well. You've got tropical storm warnings and watches all around Central Florida. Orlando, 50 to 60 mile per hour wind gusts. That'll be the peak for you, and that rain is going to be slamming in there too. So it is not just a coastal event. The breadth of this storm is going to be gigantic as it bowling balls all the way up through the eastern part of the Gulf of Mexico into the Florida Panhandle. Look at some of these wind gusting forecasts. 90 to 100 again. That's somewhere around Tallahassee Metro. Rainfall-wise, going for about 8 to 12 right there by Apalachicola. Basically, it's going to rain itself out up to the north of there. There's a good look at the swirl in the action. There is a little bit of dry air. If I could dry it, if I draw it in right there. Brian Norcross hit that before, and there's some dry air on the other side, too. But we do expect to see this stuff begin to fill in pretty nicely over the next couple of hours for sure. Now,